Tonight is Muhammad Ali's 73rd birthday. What's your personal favorite moment with Muhammad Ali?
Probably my, I mean, I broadcast about 20 of his fights, but my best moment, there'd be two of them. Of course, I was the lead announcer in the Rumble in the Jungle. Did that fight when he won the title back with George Foreman. That was a highlight, certainly. But prior to that, right before that fight, Muhammad did color commentating with me on the Norton-Foreman fight in Caracas, Venezuela. And it was spectacular because Foreman disposed of Kenny in the second round. And so I say to Ali, Ali, when you get to Africa, how do you have any shot against George Foreman? He says, Bob, he said, when I get you to Africa, he says, I'm going to put you in a pot and cook you. I mean, I had a great relationship with Muhammad because he was a Chris and Angelo Dundee fighter. And so I had a great opportunity to be around him in the gym, the Fifth Street Gym in Miami, where he trained. And so the relationship was very close. And it's hard for me to see Muhammad today in the condition he's in. But, you know, all of us are getting older. And he's accepted his fate in life and hopes that he can do a lot for the Parkinson Foundation. And so that's one of the great things about Muhammad. He's not down in the dumps. He's just not feeling too well at the moment. And it's his 73rd birthday on Saturday night.
What do you wish him for his birthday?
I wish him happy birthday, and I certainly wish him to last many, many more years in good health.
What can you tell the young generation, people watching this, Bob, that only see Ali from the little highlights, the little snippet sound bites? What should we know about that we don't know?
Well, I mean, Muhammad was an athlete that was really bigger than the sport. You got to remember, you go back into the 60s when he was an Olympic light heavyweight champ, and then he became a professional fighter and moved up into the heavyweight ranks. And he was like a messiah for black people. You know, you're talking about the era of Martin Luther King, when they still had what they call colored bathrooms in the South, when black people had to sit in the end zone at football stadiums in the South. And I mean, Ali came up through that. I mean, he was from Louisville, Kentucky. And he was the first athlete that stood up to the government. A lot of white America hated that. But he really believed in it. And as I knew Muhammad, I knew that he believed in the religion, and it was no scam. That's just how he felt, and he stuck by his guns. It cost him a lot of money, and he lost his prime years. But to black people, he changed the whole movement. In sport, he changed the whole movement because he was brash and outspoken. Prior to that, the athlete was kind of conservative and quiet and very respectful. But Ali had to talk his way into the first championship fight with Sonny Liston. So he did what he had to do. But he was will be forever remembered as one of the great self-promoters and promoters of boxing in the history of the sport. There's no question about it.
When you were broadcasting his fights, what was it like to interview him right after?
Well, I mean, because I knew him so well, a lot of it was show, like to put you in a pot and cook you in Africa. That was show. And I remember after we did that, for example, Ali said to me, how was that? How was that?
He loved it.
That was great, Muhammad. That was great.
From just being, because I wasn't there, obviously most people watching this were not there. What do you take from his boxing skills? What made him so unique? Was it the footwork? Was it the IQ? Was it the speed?
It was all of that. But on top of that, he was a great athlete. I remember one time Don Shula, the Hall of Fame coach from the Miami Dolphins, and these were during the championship years back in the 70s, he went to the Fifth Street Gym to see Muhammad work out. And all Don could say is, God, what a great tight end he would have made. and I've seen he and Jimmy Ellis shoot baskets, and they could, you know, if they went in that direction, either one of them probably could have been a great basketball player. But so he, number one, he was a great athlete. Number two, he had all the skills, the fast hands. He had the size for the time, the size, the speed, the footwork. I mean, he moved and threw his hands like a middleweight. And all those things made him the great fighter. Plus, he had tremendous ring savvy, as was proved in you know, late in his career when he came back and beat George Foreman. I mean, that wasn't a game plan by Angelo Dundee. That was his own plan in his mind to let George punch himself out. And if you ever watch that fight, folks, because they replay it an awful lot from the Rumble in the Jungle, you watch the last punch of the fight, George is circling in the center of the ring, and Ali never even had to let the right hand go. He had him exhausted. And that's how he beat George, by accumulation of punches and letting George punch himself out. So he had that ring savvy. So he had it all.
is he the greatest ever?
Yeah, but, you know, that's difficult to say because every era of boxing, you know, people that were in Joe Louis's era will say he was. People that were in the area of
Ray Robinson, Ray Leonard,
the era of the great middleweights and welterweights. And, you know, in later years, Larry Holmes was a great champion. So certainly of his time and certainly in, of all time, he's, if not the greatest, certainly one of the greatest of all time.
The last question I have to ask you, how would he do against Mike Tyson? Ali prime, Mike Tyson prime?
It would have been an interesting fight, maybe very similar to the Joe Frazier fights. In other words, I think it would have been a tough fight for Muhammad. And you know, in the final analysis, Muhammad won 2 out of 3 with Joe, and probably the same sort of thing with Mike. You know, because people that didn't know Joe Frazier see Joe, who, by the way, is this month would have been 71 years old this month, Joe Frazier. Joe could hit as hard as Mike, and Joe was the type of boxer Mike was in the early stages of Mike's career, when Mike was really, you know, a real classic boxer, more than just a knockout artist that he became in late in his career. Joe was busy all the time. So Mike against Muhammad, I think you could just say, you know, without picking winners, that it would have been very similar to Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali, so they would have been great fights.
It's funny, I ask a million people this question, I get a million different answers. But let's talk about